Hi guys, so for today's video, I'm gonna be actually doing my makeup declutter and organizing my makeup. I've been wanting to do this for a while and I found this marble tier online and I thought this would be great for everyday makeup. So I found this online yesterday and I got it. It was $16. I won it on like an auction and I thought it would be perfect for my everyday makeup. I used to use like these. The only thing is I find with clear organizers, they get scratched so quickly. I really want to try using the marble tier as my everyday makeup holder, and I actually just took some organizers that I already had, like this bin here, this one, this little bin. So I'm going to put my makeup in here. This will be my makeup drawer, and I'm hoping that this can be like my everyday makeup situation. And then I'll figure out what to do with these. But like I said, like they just get so like scratched up and it just doesn't look as good as, I don't know, this in my opinion. I went ahead and I sorted everything in categories. I don't know how much I'm gonna get rid of, but I really want to figure out what I need, what I don't want, and everything like that. Yeah, so I ended up sorting like lip, highlighter, bronzer, brushes, eye stuff, palettes. Like I gotta go through that. And all of my non-everyday makeup I'm gonna put in here, and then I'm going to organize it. All of the Mary Kay items that I have, they were sent to me. I do like honest reviews on them. So I am going to pull these four matte like Mary Kay lipsticks. I don't typically reach for a matte lipstick. And when I do, I try and use like a Mary Kay gloss just to give it something else other than that. I'm gonna keep, let me open them all. I have been trying to use up this one here. I've been trying to use this for a while. I'm getting there. So this one I'm going to keep for sure. This one for me is just a little bit too like orange. It's just not for me, so I can declutter this one. These two I think are gonna be nice in the fall with a lip gloss, so I'm going to keep them. These are lip stains. I haven't used them since they sent them to me, but I'm going to try and play around with them in the fall because these two colors I feel are more like fall colors, so I will hang on to them and try and use them. So, non-everyday makeup in here. These ones are not as matte. I believe they're like a semi-matte or they're more of a gel. So I'm going to keep them because they're really nice. These two actually change colors on your pH level, which is like really, really cool. Just watch. It'll turn like pink in a second here. See, it's coming up. It's actually so cool. This one here looks really purple. So here's the purple. Here's the pink. The pink is slowly coming, but they're really, really cool. They're really nice. I have like three unopened lip products, which I'm gonna keep. I hardly ever wear lip liners, but I'm gonna keep them because I don't have any others. My ColourPop Just a Tint, I love this. And then my Mary Kay Satin Lips, I'm gonna keep. Highlighter. So here's the Thrives Cosmetics Brilliant Eye Brightener. I have had this for a long time. I continue to use it all the time. And there's still so much product. I have used this so much and for a long time, and look at all the product. Like there's a ton. So I'm going to keep this one. This is a At Play Mary Kay stick. I have a lot of highlighter and I use this. It's really pretty, but I don't use it enough. So I'm going to pass this on. These are like the only other highlighters I have. This is it. So I'm gonna keep both of them because I do use them. My Physicians Formula Bronzer. I use this a lot and it doesn't even look like it, but this is my everyday bronzer and I use this a lot. Like there's no dent. So definitely going to keep this. I have three brow products. This is the Nude by Nature pencil and I have this for about 2 years. It lasted forever. I really liked it for a drugstore pencil. The only thing I found was the formula would be a little thick sometimes and it would be hard to blend in with my eyebrows and it would just look like too much for me personally. So I'm going to pass this on, but it lasted a long time, like a very long time. And Nude by Nature is a really nice brand. I also like how it had a spoolie on the end. My everyday brow products, this is the ColourPop brow gel, love it. It's clear, and then this one here is the Winky Luxe Universal like brow pencil. Love this because I'm not naturally blonde and I like to have some option when my roots grow in and I feel like I can go darker or lighter, so really like this. So two kind of like setting items. This here is the Urban Decay All Nighter. I use this all the time, love it. Best setting spray I've had and tried. This is the Mary Kay Translucent Powder, which I actually really have been enjoying. I used it a couple times. See how the pink is starting to come more? Anyway, I've used it a couple times and I've been enjoying it. These are my two primers I'm going to keep. I'm actually kind of excited to finish this one. I just feel like at times it's a little too slippery for me and I'd rather like a cream. So I'm just excited to almost be done this one. Move on to my Hello Fab Coconut Skin one. Foundation and concealer. I have been using the Revlon Candid Concealer for a long time. Actually, it should be done this month and I'll purchase a new one. I actually want to purchase a little bit more makeup this month, but anyway, this is really good drugstore concealer if you want a medium coverage concealer. Why was that so hard to say? If you want a medium coverage concealer, this one is a great drugstore option. For foundation, I've actually just been using this Hawaiian Tropic BB sunscreen. It's tinted, it has SPF 30, it's good until next year. So I'm really trying to use this up as much as I can, and I've really been enjoying it. It's nice and light on the skin, it adds some nice color, and I just love it. So this has been my quote unquote foundation this year. So let's move into some eye products. This here is the CoverGirl Lash Blast Fusion. I'm going to take this out of my collection because I have been using this for about 3 months and I like to switch my mascaras after 3 months. This one wasn't bad, but it wasn't my favorite. I feel like with the time, as the formula got more dry, it built up a lot better. It's not the same as the orange one from CoverGirl, so I'm gonna put this in my empties. This will be my new mascara. This is the Love Lash Fenorma from Mary Kay, so I will give this a try for 3 months. This is an eyeliner from Mary Kay, which I haven't tried yet, but I'm gonna keep it. This here is the ColourPop eyeliner. I love this eyeliner. When this is done, I will be buying another one from ColourPop, so I really enjoy it. I have two other eyeliners. This one from Mary Kay seemed to dry out fast, and I find with this one, it just skips a lot and it dried out quickly, so this one can go. This one here is the tattoo liner that I had as a sample from Sephora. It's from the Kat Von D line. It's just too small for me to grab onto. Like, I'm not good with liquid eyeliner, and for it being a mini size, it's just too hard for me to control. So I'm gonna get rid of this one. This here is the Mary Kay cream eyeshadow. I did enjoy this. The only thing is, I feel like because my skin can get dry sometimes, this won't work all the time for my eyelids. So I'm gonna pass this on to my sisters who may enjoy this more. All of these liquid eyeshadows from Mary Kay I will keep. I do use them quite often. Okay, this is the Mary Kay eye primer. I'm going to keep this. I actually really enjoy it. Let's get into my palettes here. So this one here is the Jeffree Star and Shane Dawson Mini Controversy. I'm going to declutter this one. I just hardly use it. This is a Mary Kay palette that I put two single shadows and a bronzer in. The bronzer is just too deep for my skin tone, and the two shades here I don't use often, so I'm gonna declutter these. I'm sure my sisters would like them. All right, the Morphe palette. This one I don't use a lot, but I'm going to keep it for one more round until I get another palette just to see if I can use it up some more. My Tati Beauty palette, I use this literally all the time, so I'm gonna keep it. The two ColourPop eyeshadow palettes I'm keeping, I use them a lot. The Hot Buttered Rum by Too Faced, keeping it. The Mary Kay little palette here, I use these all the time. I love these, and this bronzer is more of my shade. This here is the Jaclyn Hill palette, the original one. I'm going to hang on to this one as well because I do use it a lot. And I feel like this is my more colorful palette. So, these here. Let's talk about these. I've gone through my brushes a couple months ago, so I'm going to keep these until I get new ones. This sponge, I feel like it's time to go. This is still okay. This needs to go. It's starting to like unform, which is weird. Like I can't get the sponge back to normal. And I have used this since the day I got it, all the time. This is what I use all the time. So I feel like I got my money's worth. It was a great tool. Now I can open a new one. This from Mary Kay, I just started to use for powders. So I'm going to keep it. And then I'm going to actually open this up so I can use a new Blendiful. So that's that. Look at the difference here. Like you can tell that I have used this like a lot. Like it's so used. This one's not as much. The Baby Blendiful, not as much for me, but definitely the big one. Like that's just crazy. So this is gonna go. This will go in here, this can go, and I will keep these two. Okay, here's my little mini declutter pile. Honestly, it's more than I thought I would get rid of, so yay for me. These are products that I use every single day, so I'm going to put those in the marble tier and see how it looks, and then we'll go from there. So here is basically all of my everyday makeup. I feel like that doesn't look too bad. I feel like I can grab everything that I need and I know what's there. I really like that. Like this I can create an everyday look with. So now I'm gonna use these and I'm gonna actually organize my other makeup that I don't use every single day. It's only been like maybe 2 seconds that it's been like this, but I am loving this so much more. I can see all of my brushes that I have. I can see all of my highlighters, my liquid eyeshadows, my eyeliner, all of my lip products. Like all of my lip products are here. My face products, I have like my extra primer here. My little eyeshadow palettes. In here is literally all of my everyday makeup. I have two palettes here that are too big to fit in this drawer. So I'm going to keep them just like that for right now. I'm just wondering, what do I do with this? Because I hardly use it and I don't know what to do with it because I don't want to keep it out and I don't have any room in here. I'm wondering if this is my sign to like declutter it. But this is just so much better. I will want to get different organizers probably in the fall, but for right now, this is just so nice. One drawer, one tier, and that's all I need. So I really hope that you guys enjoyed this video, and it was more so just to kind of go through my makeup, see what I need, because I do want to pick up a little bit more, reorganize it. I'm happy that it's in one drawer, one tier. I think this marble tier is going to be so cool, and it's so me. And now I just have to figure out what to do with these organizers because I'm not gonna use them. The clear ones are nice, but it's just that they get so scuffed up so quickly. This will be organized soon along with my hair care, so make sure to subscribe, ring the bell to be notified when this goes up, and I will catch you in the next one. Bye.